just doing what's right for you. And that's important. So we're not putting pressure on you to be the best. We just want you to have the best of the experience today. Okay? So you know how to see us. What the next thing that will happen is there'll be a change of music. And then that means that we're recording. So this is all recorded. We don't see you in the recordings, but you can see us kind of looking at the screen. So behind the scene, we can see you. Does anybody have any questions before we begin?
No.
No? We're all good. Lovely. So let's do this. Can you wave at me?
Participants, there's 24 people taking part.
Yeah, there's 24 people taking part. I know. So waving behind the scenes, our colleague Nick is watching. We're watching. So Nick's doing her hands. There you go. And she's telling us, you know, so she's keeping an eye on. Also on your Zoom, you can chat to us, so you can write a message. So, and that's quite a useful tool here. So we've already, you know, if you've got to collect someone from Amazon, not the Amazon. So if you've got a delivery and somebody's knocking on your door, you can always put that in the chat. If you've got a private question you want to ask, you can privately ask myself, Helen Ty, or Pat Taylor
in the room.
And I just wanted to say I've had a few questions, so we will, and it sounds awful, but we will pop your microphones on mute so that you can't speak to us, but it just means that we're not being rude, it just means that you don't get all the background noises and then you see only us and you hear only us, so it makes it easier.
Okay.
So please don't feel offended by that. And if you, yeah, and the other thing I'd like to say is most of you have got your names on, which is great, because we just need to know who you are for our safety, for your safety, and just so that we know who we're dealing with, but also to just let you know how to change that. So for instance, we've got a couple of people and it just says iPhone, so we're not sure who you are. So if we could ask you to change that to either your name or initials or something and let us know, that would be really good. And I believe you do that. Is that the three dots as well, isn't it? There's three dots at the top.
And
thank
it says
you.
Rename.
It says rename. So you can just rename yourself. And if you want to just do that for this meeting,
can I be called Tallulah?
No, you can't.
I've always had to be called Tallulah.
I could give you another name, but I'm probably not allowed to.
I think I might do that today. Tallulah Tite.
And just another safety issue is if you are feeling unwell or you need to leave the meeting, please pop it in the chat or let us know, because we will follow it up with a phone call. And it's fine to turn your cameras off if you want to. Just let us know, just so that we do know, because we'll be keeping an eye on you. And that's really important. The link will be the same each week. So save your emails, but we do send out regular newsletters to keep you updated. And feed back anything to us. You know, we're more than happy for you to go, that was really great, I really loved that, or I really found that a bit difficult, could you include whatever. So,
or if you want to do fancy dress, or you want to listen to music,
or if you want Christmas songs, come into Christmas, we've got a great one. So, and the most important thing is only do what you are capable of today. So next week you might feel really different, or you might feel not as well next week. Only do what you are capable of today. But it's good to stay in, because at the end we always do relaxation and mindfulness, which is just lovely, and breathing. So that's my bit.
Right then, let's go. I think I might take my glasses off because I'm a little bit steamy.
Are you?
Yeah. I can't put them in my head like that.
Give me.
Because it steams up my glasses.
Okay.
Okay. Do you want me to I think I'll be fine. Right. Okay. Hello and good morning. I'm Helen Tite, and with me today is Pat Taylor, and we are delivering Renu. Renu is our program. Now, we've actually been teaching this for a very long time, and it has been just updated as the science and the information has given us, as we're staying up to date. But also we've added in long COVID because we do recognise, obviously, there is a need to support people that are going through recovery. So this programme will come in chunks. You can do whichever bit you want to do. You can do all of it, or you can just do bits of it. And there's no pressure, all right? But the important thing is you're here. And we're going to start with some gentle movement. But before we do that, we've got to think about our posture, okay? Today, you'll notice we're in little chairs. We're not standing up. Renu is not for standing yet. So comfortable in the chairs, we're looking for good posture. So in order to do that, what I'd like you to do is move your back away from the back of the chair. I want you to sit up. So, and the idea behind this is that this is what we call self-supporting spine. This is strengthening the muscles simply by sitting away from the back of a chair, is strengthening your core muscles and your postural muscles. So for some of us, that can be more of a challenge than others, but it is really important to practice this a few minutes a day. So move away from the back of your chair and sit up nice and tall. Okay, as we do that, I want you to also think about lifting up through your center. So, you know, as if, I sounded so serious for such a long time. I was like really doing my best to sound really serious. It's like you got a bit of wind. And I say it like that. So you've got a bit of wind and you want to have a bit of a bottom clench because you don't want to let it go, all right? So you need to kind of connect and contract in your undercarriage. We will get to undercarriage. See that? That's how my hands... So I need you to think about what you're sat on and create tension there. But can you please relax your shoulders and not put your eyebrows up on the top of your head, please? So I'm lifting up through the pelvic floor, drawing my belly into my backbone and sitting tall, self-supporting spine. That's it. So just to practice this for a little time is really important. Okay, and then from here, let's roll our shoulders. When we are sat for long periods of time, we get achy here, we hold tension here, but slowly, gently roll those shoulders. You might surprise yourself, you might actually feel quite well as a result of it. Okay, now, what if we did one at a time? Nothing is rushed, everything is within your own movement. You don't have to stay at the same pace as us. The idea is we're slowly working together to improve joint action. Come on, Jim. One more each side. Well done. Okay. So from here, I'd like us to take our hands onto the opposite shoulders. So fingers cross over onto opposite shoulders. And we're just going to slowly rotate to one side, come back through center, and repeat to the other side. So I'm hoping already you're getting the vibe for we're doing this nice and gently. There is no pressure here. So don't believe that I'm lulling you into a false sense of security. Beryl, you in? Some of you might just watch today, but because it's recorded, you can play it back and do it in your own time. Lovely. And Sarah, are you okay? Now, I'm finding doing my hands across my shoulders a bit too much, so I'm just sliding my hands up and down my thighs, enabling me to twist. Hands across onto opposite shoulders. Still, great move. But this is about mobilizing the spine. So we've all seen the skeletons. So the bits between where the bones meet is cartilage and juicy, squidgy, spongy stuff. And what we're doing here is making those joints, the bits that connect the joints together, just a bit more buttery. And that's really important. So if we loosen up those joints, then we can really start to support the muscles. Okay, lovely. Let's take right ear down to right shoulder and just pause it there for a second. Take a big fat breath in and breathe out. Okay, bring your head back to center. Give yourself a minute and let's take the ear down to the other side. Hold it there. Enjoy how that feels. Come back to centre. That's not too bad, right? Okay, let's take the ear back down, right ear and right shoulder. Let's just be conscious on the left side. See if we can just stretch the left arm a bit longer.
Try and drop your shoulders down a bit. Some of you are like that.
Come back to centre. Yeah,
lovely.
Left ear down to left shoulder. Right arm, just lengthen it. And just feel a bit of a stretch through the shoulder, through the neck. Well done. And come back to centre. Good, 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 good. Okay, so from here, I just want you to give me some heel toe movements, please. So even though we are sat, we still need to mobilise ankles, knees and hips. And partly because we just don't want fluid to build up in your ankles. We've got to keep the circulation moving and boosted. So it's always, always important just to keep those feet going, okay? You're doing really well. So far, so good. Can I have a thumbs up? Tell me that you're all right. Lovely. And this is paced nicely. You're okay? Not freaking out. Yay. Good. Thank you. I think that was Deborah. Lovely. Okay. So we've got the ankles going. As a result, the hips are going. Work to your own pace. Lovely. Okay. And now what we're going to do is just wiggle jiggle feet wider. Bring the feet together and then take the feet wider. Bring them together. So, Owen, are you there? Can we switch cameras a minute? You stay where you are, our kid. Now, again, recognising what's going on with our health. Not everyone can do this, so we might need to have a few conversations with our feet. Now, remember, when we're delivering this class, we're doing it to camera. It's being recorded. You need to do what works for you. So if, for example, you're somebody who's had a stroke and you are lacking in mobility on one side, don't feel you're missing out, okay? This is you having conversations with your body and doing what works for you. Please do never put, we never put pressure on people in Renu. However, if you were doing Pilates, I'd kick your bum. I'm joking. Right, okay, so we've got ankles going. So ankles, knees and hips are going. Now the next thing I want you to do is to leave your feet nice and wide, and we're just gonna have a little side lean. Now this has always been a favorite of mine, partly because in reality, you go for a wee in somebody else's house and sod's law, the loo roll is not where you want it to be. So we have to go, oh, crikey, and you've got to lean and find that loo roll. Or you lean over and you're sat at home and the newspaper's not where it is, or the remote controls are not where they are. So this is a movement that is really valid to life. Okay, feet nice and wide though, because that's a really lovely, stable, wide base of support. So the closer your feet are together, the more your balance is challenged. The further your feet are apart, then you're more stable, okay? Come back to center and just release. Okay, my loves. So what makes this one different to the other classes we teach? Well, we look at the nervous system. We look at what makes you stressed, what makes you calm. We look at what triggers. And a lot of today is just about us getting to know you. And here I am, I've taken my glasses off and I'm just touching my face. I want you to do the same. So we are going to start at our ears. And I just want you to just put a little bit of pressure to the underside of your cheekbones and push up. Okay, I'm gonna go a bit closer, this camera, okay. Okay, right. So what I'm trying to do is pinch around the jaw and press my teeth upwards. Good job, I did a chin wax earlier on. Okay, and this bit here, so just at the front, oh, doesn't that feel nice? Anyone think that's nice? Mm. Yeah, it's lovely, isn't it? What about this? okay, don't go, what's she doing? Right, okay, so this is, it helps to release the sinuses. And some of you might be clenchers, not bottom teeth. So this is a really nice way to release your jaw. Okay, now what I need you to do is just take your jaw side to side and then pull some faces with your face. This I always find just makes you feel even more itchy. End up getting an itchy nose when you do this. Okay, right, and the reason we're doing this is because we're just going to have a look at our jaw and our breath, and that's the next chunk of what we're about to do. Okay, so your teeth, your bottom teeth, come forward and then back. Forward and back.
Bear with me.
Forward and back. Last time, forward and back. Okay, chin goes up, 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 up. And then those teeth come forward. Oh, 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 oh. You get a lovely, lovely, lovely stretch through the neck, okay? Come back to center, back to me, in the eyes. Right, now this time your chin comes down to your chest. Hold it there. Now if you want to, you can give the back of your neck and skull a bit of a massage. So I'm just gonna turn my head on the side here. Oh, I wish I brushed my hair this morning. Right, what you can do is just massage up the back of the head and neck as your chin is on your chest. Now again, really important here because we do carry so much stress in our body and it all connects. Lovely, so chin to chest and just press around the back of the skull and then come back to me. Well done. So that's something that you can practice at home. Okay, so let's have a look at that again. So wiggle jiggle of your nose, like you've got an itchy nose or a itchy face. Bottom teeth come forward and backwards. Ooh, 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 ooh. I know it looks completely bonkers, but bear with, okay. And then I need you to look up. Bottom teeth go over. Ooh, 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 ooh. And you get that lovely stretch, isn't it? Okay, and then chin down onto your chest and give the back of your head a bit of a massage. Like really focus on those bumps in the back of your head. Well done, come back to me. Now smile, going, what on earth was all that about? Okay. It's method in the madness. Okay, so we're gonna talk about breath next. So firstly, I want you to take a long breath in through the nostrils if you can, and then a slow, controlled breath out. Breath in, make it audible, breath out. Let's do that again. So we're breathing in, put your hands on your belly, breathe out, breathe in through the back of the nostrils, let the belly swell, breathe out. It's okay to cough. Okay, rest, because that's a lot of oxygen going on through your body. Okay, now we're gonna have a little go at a huff here. So a short puff out. Breath in, puff out. Breath in, huff out. And then settle. Let's do that again. Take a breath in, huff, out. Good, 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 good. Do you think we could do this one more time? How are you doing, Chris? Thumbs up, breath in. Okay, so now we're gonna slowly exhale. Inhaling, breath in. Exhaling slow, slow. So you don't have to follow my rate and rhythm. What's really important here is that we just breathe. But focus on trying to slow it if you can and allow the ex breath, the ex out, breathe and out breath just to take a little bit longer each time. So I'm hoping your face, head and neck feels a bit better already. Give me a thumbs up, how are we doing? Are we okay? So far, so good. Marvellous. Okay, well done. So, You can always drink some water if you need some. Okay. Can we switch cameras again, please? Honestly, I did have curly hair this morning. Well done. Drink some water, catch your breath for a second. So when we started this program, the question was, how are we going to work with so many people with different health conditions? And what we wanted to achieve is trying to make you feel like you've had a deep tissue massage by the end of each session. Okay, so if you're able now, I'd like you to take your hands to your hands down on your thighs, and then hands up on your thighs. Okay, and then take your hands out. Long breath in, exhale, bring your hands together, and then down again. So palm down, lift, palm up and out, squeeze your shoulder blades, come back in, palms down and rest. So the flow,
sorry,
well done, up, out. You keep going in and down. What I'm looking for here is the chest to stay lifted, self-supporting spine, belly into backbone. This movement again works between the shoulder blades. Lovely. And gently breathe. All you need to do, just breathe nice and gently. Yeah, I love this. If you feel tired, tell me, all right? This is about the shoulder girdle, the rotator cuff is what it's called. Lovely, last time. Out, up, in, and together. Okay, let's do that again. So we go out, and together. Well done. Let's take that again. Breathing in, breathing out. Inhaling. Well done. Well done, Dick. So you can see this is working with the breath. And if you're starting to yawn, then my job is done. This again, it's tapping into your nervous system, this movement. And I'm allowing your breath to marry with your arms. Breathing in last time. Now watch, here's a change. Palms down and settle. Palms up, lift, rotate, and come back down again. Palms up, up, scoop, rotate. This is a bit of brain gym, because you'll walk out and you go, I have no idea what we've just done. Well done. And again, breath in. Last time, breath in. And release. Good job. Feel okay? Yeah, we're all right. Okay, so we're in our seated position. I want you just to shift weight. So we are literally lifting onto one bum cheek, settling down, and then rocking onto the other bum cheek. Settling down. So lean in and settle in. Good job. And lean in. And settling. It's fine, right? Okay. As you move, let's assume we're moving to the left. I want you to push the right leg down into the ground a bit firmer. Okay, lovely. And then push the left leg into the ground a bit firmer. Can we switch cameras again, Owen, please? So we're pushing down. So you might feel stronger in the leg as you push from side to side. Now, you never have to completely copy us, all right? If you think, oh, well, what if I added in a stretched arm and dropped my shoulder? Do it. So this is about, we've just got to set a baseline for you guys. We've got to look at what you can do in sit, and then we'll have a look of other options as the weeks go on.
For next week, thank you, Jess, for your message. Make sure you're in a stable chair, okay? It does help.
Not a swivel chair.
Just be careful today. So feet really wide, and just make those movements smaller if you're not in a stable chair.
Well done.
Remember just to do as many as you can, and then rest.
So a bit of science. As you're shifting from sit bone to sit bone, this also helps to release fascias. It's called fascias in the body. So in fact, taught this in Pilates this morning. So the shifting, and really sit on your sit bone as you shift forward and backwards. If you feel like you're on your bum cheeks, you're not set up enough. I need you to go a bit taller. So if you feel you're sat on your bum cheeks, we need you up as you rock side to side. Okay, well done. And then release. Have a little jiggle, 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 jiggle. No, you can do that, you know. It is a... No, genuine, do
what?
It. Oh. This always makes me chuckle because you kind of go... What? Wrong bra.
Yeah.
Little jiggle, 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 jiggle. Lovely. I tell you what, Sarah. I'm not sure what that white thing is on your t-shirt, but
oh, it's a man.
It's fantastic. Jiggle, 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 jiggle. So this again, it's really nice because it increases blood flow, it makes you feel a bit tingly. It's a nice thing. Okay, well done. Okay, now watch my feet. So from my chair, I'm stepping forward and stepping back. That's it. Forward, back, back. Forward, forward, back, back. Got it? Forward, forward, back, back. So remember what I was saying. Sometimes you have to do a bit of brain gym. Okay, so we're going to go right, left, right, left. Left, right, left, right. Right, left, right, left. Left, right, left, right. I can't tell you how hard this is. Right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right. And again, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right. And again, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And again, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Two more rounds. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
It's David Attenborough on the t-shirts.
Who is it?
David Attenborough.
Oh, is it?
I thought it was.
Fantastic.
I knew it was David somebody. I couldn't think
fantastic.
Of his surname.
Okay, so here we are. We're in the front third of your chair. Nice and tall, self-supporting spine. Make sure you've got a lovely, nice, wide base of support so you feel comfortable in your chair. Lovely. Now, we're coming back to arms, okay? So it's a big picture. So we go nice and wide, one hand high, one hand low, and back, squeeze shoulders. Come back together, and then opposite sides. Now, what I want you to do is look down to right hand, look to me, and then down to left hand, and then look to me. Look up to right hand. Ooh, and look at me, look up to left hand. And then look at me, look down to right hand.
Blimey. I have to think about that.
Yeah, I know, this is what I'm saying. Look down to left
Colette
hand.
Colette does too.
You will feel tired at the end of the session, I promise you. Look up to right hand. There you go. Look up to left hand. Well done. Look down to right hand. Look down to left hand. It's like we're tricking them. Mm. It's not, honestly, and then rest your shoulders. It's a lot. So again, with all many neurological conditions, there's this fatigue, this sensation of fatigue. So, and this is brain gym. So this really does fire you up, and then you will feel really quite tired afterwards, but in a refreshed kind of way, which is quite nice. Okay, lovely. So shoulders, chest, we've worked neck and head already. We're moving down, we've worked with the legs a little bit, and now what I'd like us to do is, sat in the front third of your chair, I want you just to come forward and rest your chest or belly onto your thighs, and then from there push up and lean back so your shoulders touch the back of your chair. So we come up nice and tall, lean all the way forward so you're looking down, so there might be a bit of a spinal stretch here. You push out of the chair, legs, arms, chair, sit back. Oh, there's a couple of things, because we're new friends, right? So you got to have a little allowances for me and Pat, because we're menopausal women, we get hot and forget everything.
Yeah.
So there's got to be a little bit of an allowance for us. So the interesting thing when you're leaning forward and backwards here, when you come forward, that's quite the stretch in your back. So enjoy that feeling. And when you lean forward, we need to start thinking about tightening up your pelvic floor.
It's good for your breathing though, isn't it?
It's great for breathing. Ooh. And then nice and back, nice and tall, pelvic floor lifted. Lean forward, see my eyebrows went up. Lean forward, enjoy the stretch in the back. Roll up, roll back. So we can make this a bit more fluid if you want to. So we're rolling forward, rolling up and rolling back. Lovely, thanks Jane. So chest down, head down, flop, rise up and tall. So again, you keep going, so follow Pat. Is a flow down and a flow up, and we're just kind of letting the body become soft and using abdominals. Sal, I just need to know you're okay there, my love. Yeah, good. Oh, she's knackered, lovely.
And I can use my arms, can't I? I can have my hand, use my hands, can't I, to help me get up and back?
Of course. Yeah. There's no rules. That's the great thing about this. There are no rules. You just need to do what feels right for you. Well done. Lovely. Sure?
Yeah, we finished.
Cool, pass. Okay. Well done.
Sign off now.
Are you all tired now? You might feel quite tired now. Are we okay? Can I have a thumbs up that you're all really sleepy and chilled? Have I got that? Are you all nice and chilled? Brilliant. And that's really where we're going with this. We want you to feel utterly relaxed and that you've stretched and moved yourselves. Okay, so as we do that, you're still sat up in yourself to supporting the spine. I want you to bring the heels of your hands together. Okay, so use a wall if we haven't got arms working fully. Okay, then from there, I want you to touch fingertip and thumb. Okay, so come to me, show me, and then up. Okay, then I need you to go up and down. Show me. Right, okay. We're stretching off at the elbows. Push up, draw down. Now watch. I'm going to this time try and get my elbows to touch. And push up and down and straighten off my arms. Elbows touch, push, down and press. Down, push, down and press. Now you might feel this here. So they might have feel a bit squishy, a bit squashed, but you might feel this into your chest and into your neck. Well done. And then release. Lovely. Shake off your hands. Okay. Hands on your thighs. I just want you to roll your shoulders. So it looks like this. Just watch for a second. We are pushing your shoulder forward and back and using your hands to roll forward and back. Keep your hands where they are. Just bring one shoulder forward and back. lovely for releasing, again, around the shoulder. Again, with breathing and breath, it's so important. Anything that involves releasing off around the rib cage. It's nice, isn't it? It's like lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay, last time, go forward and backwards and shaky, 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 shake. Bring that in a minute. Right, okay. And then ask them behind camera. Okay, so the next thing I want you to do is to bring the hands together, and I just want you to lift your elbows. So if you can see this, right? So the idea is your hands are together, you push down into your fingertips and up again. Again, our hands get really tight and achy, so it's a really nice feeling to feel released off here. Then hands, thumbs, curl your fingers in, wrap your thumbs over and roll your wrists in and out, got it? Okay, release your hands, palms up, roll your hands in and out. I'm just going to show you, roll in and out, well done, in and out. Okay, right, thumbs in your palms, wrap your fingers around, roll wrists in and out. So you should feel quite some lovely stretches around the wrist, around the forearm to the elbow in that sequence. So let's do that again. Oh, let's finish. So thumbs up, curl hands in, thumbs over, and we're rolling in and out. Palms out, curl hands in and out. Lovely. And then thumbs into the palms, securely grab your thumbs, we roll in and out. So again, it's something that we can just have a little play with. It does make you feel like you've moved, because you think, because we get so stiff in our hands, so it's a really nice thing to release. Good job. Okay, so take your left hand if you can, and I want it to just sit on the right side of your head, gently pressing your left ear down to your left shoulder. This will just create a bigger stretch here into the neck. So again, what you can do using your right hand on your neck is just to press gently around where that tightness is. And then release. Good job. Likey? No likey. Likey? Right hand to the left side of the head. Ooh. Everything went quick then. Okay, so it's a gentle pull. And then again, what you can do is take your left hand and just a gentle palpate, a little press, a little massage, where you might have a little sweet spot there that just needs like, just like release off a little bit. Well done. And come back to center. Now, this is the good stuff. Do we get music? We're gonna try music, okay. Okay, right. Okay, so what I'd like you to do before we play some music is to relax with us. So we're going to do a thing called the happiness tree. Some of you have done this with us previously, and it is a relaxation. So important with Renu to help you to relax and de-stress. And also, just you're wonderful, and we're so pleased that you're here. So we really want to support you. And I will teach... our team teaches relaxation, mindfulness and meditation pretty much with every class we teach these days, because stress is on the agenda and we need to keep people less stressed. Control the things you can control, the stuff you can't control, we got to learn to let that go. Okay, so I need you to relax. How'd you do that? You sit back in your chair and you take some long breaths. You need to close your eyes. This is all the good stuff, guys. And it's really important. Not yet, in a sec. So, with your eyes closed, we're gonna go on a little journey. and we are going to start by taking some long breaths. And we're going to use this to energize us. We're going to use our story, the happiness tree, to hopefully make you feel uplifted. But listen to my words and connect with the story. So when you're ready, Owen. Happiness is elusive. It seems to be something we mostly strive, or something we mostly promise ourselves, strive for in a future moment. We say to ourselves, when I have this, or when I feel well, or when I get this, then I'll be happy. Or is it something we remember from a past experience? Those were the happy days, or I was happy then. Rarely do we stop and think, right here, right now, in this moment, I am happy. Happiness is a decision that you can make each day. As soon as you open your eyes in the morning, you can set your intention and say to yourself, today will be a great day. Today, I will be the very best that I can be. Today, I will be happy. Now, if your day is not going how you want it to, it is quite likely that situations will arise that will start to diminish your happiness levels. If your day is not going the way you want it to, and you remember perhaps when you were a child, or maybe on your wedding day, or a special occasion. Think back to those moments when you were truly happy. Find your happiness growing. Bring that memory to this moment in time. And try this exercise with me. Ah, big sigh. With your eyes closed, plot a picture a small plot of earth, it may be in your garden or an allotment, on your favourite field or hillside. And bend gently, make a small hole. Then plant a tiny brown seed into this hole and sit back and watch it. This seed is your happiness, and it's got no worries or concerns or anxieties. Pat the earth back over it. Wait. Now focus your attention on this tiny seed below. See it swelling, growing bigger and bigger until a tiny root bursts out of it, and then a tiny shoot. The root spreads out and grows downwards, anchoring itself into the earth as the shoot pushes its way through the soil until it reaches the air and the light. It quickly bursts. It bursts into leaf and grows upwards and outwards. Feel your happiness growing and expanding with it. As it grows, the tree sends out side shoots. More leaves, always growing, increasing in size and spreading. Feel your happiness growing from your heart area and expanding to fill your whole body until it reaches your face and you smile. Now your tiny seed is a glorious tree of happiness, your happiness. It needs nothing more. It's perfect right here, right now. It is a graceful tree with sunshine in its branches, joy in its leaves. as you were a person filled with happiness and the joy of life. You are ready to be the very best that you can be, and your happiness, that will flow from you and it will reach everyone you meet. Recall this tree. We'll practice this exercise whenever you need to lift your spirits. Take a little breath in. And release. Well done, guys. Okay. Don't need to play the music again. Well done. Are you awake? Are you with me? When you're ready, come back into the space and give me a thumbs up or fingers. It's lovely. Brilliant. Okay, Owen, thank you. Okay, so today we've introduced ourselves. You've got a feeling for what we're about to do with you. We went through a circulation boost and a warm-up with you. And from there, we started having a look at some exercises that are really good from a seated position that are excellent at resettling, if you like, the nervous system. These exercises we've used previously working in neurological programs, and we're bringing them back to hopefully assist you. We had a look at breath. We attempted some breathing together. We did some stretching. We did some myofascial release. We've actually done quite a lot of work in a short amount of time. So it's interesting to get some feedback from you to see how you felt that went. And then we finished the session with some mindfulness. And that again is really important to help you have some really good quality rest rather than feeling fatigued. So that's us. I'm Helen Tite, and you've met Pat Taylor today. We are Renew, delivering iCareiMove. And for us, you know, it's like we're in a different environment. So we're, it's a challenge to be able to deliver this without actually getting our hands on you, which is our favourite thing because we love a good old kutch, and we love like to touch. To try and support you, but it'd be really good now if you could just spend a few minutes giving us some feedback and tell us how you felt that went, and is there something specific you would like us to add to the program as we move forward? Yes, please. Don't go all shy on me.
I thought it was good. The brain gym certainly makes your brain work. You seem got tired.
I know, so you feel tired, Sal.
Sorry?
You feel tired?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
It was good.
I don't know quite how to say this, but I enjoyed it.
You enjoyed it?
Yeah.
Good. I'm glad you did. Nice to meet you.
Good, thank you.
Alana, look at your lovely smiley face.
Me?
Yeah, she's like, oh, me. How did you find that, sweetheart?
Me?
Yeah, Alana, how did you find that?
That was pitched exactly at the right level for me.
Brilliant. Great. That's what we want to hear. Welcome to the
And I found the breathing and the huffing very helpful. I have... one of the things I struggle with is severe asthma. So, yeah, it was enough to try and just start things moving in my chest and clearing my airways a little bit.
Great. That's great to hear. Brilliant. Thank you. Jane, how did you find that?
Yes. I mean, obviously, I've just done a Pilates class with you. So it was nice. The additional things for me were face. I think that was fabulous. I don't think I've ever done that before. And the breath, that really does help, especially as I've just got over a bad cold.
Yeah.
And it was lovely to connect with everybody here today. So nice to see everybody.
Oh, thank you, Jane.
And the feet, especially those feet in and out. My feet, I can't feel them. So. Yeah. That was lovely.
Well, you've unmuted it.
Brilliant. Excellent. Thank you. Over to Sarah with David Attenborough on a T-shirt. You're on mute at the moment, lovely.
Hello.
There we go.
You right, sweetheart?
Yeah, I sent you a little message there. I'm sure you've seen it. I really liked the mixture of the whole body movements, as well as the face and the breathing.
Okay. I've just read your message. Right, okay.
Yeah, you don't have to read it out, it's okay.
Yeah, no, I got it.
And I'd be really interested in looking at your Pilates stuff. Although I haven't been moving for a little while, I was doing Pilates.
Okay.
So I really like this session to get again, but in a few weeks, I'd really like to increase.
Great. That's, and all of that.
I'm sorry, my love, because I've got a couple of conditions, I find if I don't have an actual scheduled exercise time, I just never get round to it at home.
Yeah.
So this is.
What was that, Graham?
You're the same.
I said, I know exactly what he feels.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
That's funny. Excellent. Sorry I'm late this morning, love. I got the time all wrong.
That's all right, darling. What about yourself, Deborah?
Fun.
Deborah, I was just talking to Deborah. How's she doing?
No.
You're on mute, babe.
Regular exercise time.
Hello.
You're still on mute, Deborah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you're sorting yours out. Rob, are you all right, love?
Yes, I'm fine. I've had a rough few weeks, but I'm back now. I thought that was very well pitched, although I would like to see a bit more on breathing.
More on breathing. Okay. What I didn't want to do is trigger coughing. So I was just trying to get a feel for you, because Pat was saying, I need to know exactly what you're doing. And I was like, do you know what? Until we've met them and got our hands on you, it's difficult to pitch. So now that I know what I've got and what I'm dealing with, then we can explore certain areas. Absolutely. And the nice thing about this program, it's not graded. So you don't start at sort of day one and then we want you to improve week on week. We'll just listen to you. And then some weeks we'll put a stronger emphasis on certain areas, but you'll never feel like you've missed out. Each week will be slightly different with a slightly different focus.
We'll have a bit more time next week as well, because we won't have to go through all of the explanations and everything. So
yeah, this is like the test number one. You know, the first session. Gavin, hello. Can you come off mute and give me some feedback? Are you right, lovely boy?
Yeah. So I enjoyed that. So not having a brilliant day today. So I think the exercise was pitched just at the right level for me today. No, it's not enough to trigger any kind of reaction or anything. But I really enjoyed the breathing, and particularly the mindfulness bit at the end.
Worked for you.
Really good.
Cool. Great. Thank you.
Jess is smiling there. He's looking like he's a bit naughty there.
Hi, sweetheart. You all right?
Helen?
Yeah?
We seem to have a problem with the technology at the moment. I've clicked on unmute, and then we've got ourselves on the full screen. I don't know whether everybody else has got that. And then now we've lost your picture completely.
I think that's to do with the view in the corner, so your far right-hand corner.
Yeah.
Well, it says it's on speaker.
Go back
to
gallery.
Did I put it on full
screen? Go to gallery.
Gallery, okay.
And then you can see all the ruffians.
The lovely people.
She says ruffians. I'm like Rogue's Gallery.
No, we don't have you on full screen when you're speaking.
Okay, I think we need to contact you.
Yeah,
and
we'll give you a call, Liv.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, cool.
Yeah, we'll give you a call and talk you through it.
It says Jess.
Yes, that's me.
Oh, hi.
Hello,
Jess.
Okay, well, how did you find that?
I found out that you're more flexible than I am.
Oh.
You can be with the old ones. I can't get that one in.
Yeah, that is quite a challenge. absolutely. I love that. You're all going, no, oh, yeah. I couldn't do that. You're all doing that, go, no, couldn't do that.
I couldn't do it. I could hardly do it. I'm like, oh.
My boobs get in the way, to be fair. But it's really good for stretching out here in your arm. So it is a really good one. So it might be that you're here to start with, but eventually it'll come. And it is really good for the shoulders. Good. And particularly if you're a seated person, so if you're in a chair a lot, that movement is really good to help you with your pressing off chairs. So it's all connected. There's absolute method in the madness.
But the brain work, is very good with the feet. So confuse me then.
Yeah, I'm really sorry about that. It's hard, isn't it? Yeah. But it's, again, it's really important because it's stimulating the central nervous system, and that's what we want to happen, to help you with your pacing and try not to get too fatigued. So it means that we can do more with you in a short amount of time.
Yeah. I'm not ready for Strictly yet.
My toes, when I watch Strictly, are like that. Like, the whole time, my toes are just going, duh, 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 and it's just a standing joke. Are you like that?
I love that when they go all floaty. I'm there with them.
Right, well done. So, you will get an email.
Yes, you will. You'll get an email of the recording. So, I'll send you, we used to call it the video, I'll send you the recording of today. So, I'll send that out later. So, that is what you've just done, recorded. You can do it again, you can watch it back, but and please save it, or we'll just send it out again. And then I will send you a newsletter at the weekend to give you the link again to get back into the meeting. It is-